Okay, let's start with our discussion on the IPRA law. As we mentioned earlier, no, this is a very important law covering a significant portion of significant portion of the land area of the country. So what is the impact of the Indigenous Peoples Rights Act law on the real estate industry? So just a brief history, you know, for us to have a knowledge of what this law is all about. For more than 300 years, no, of Spanish colonization, our country has been we have a lot of what you call native peoples, no, scattered all over our 7,000 islands, and they were subjugated and eventually surrendered, not under Spanish rule. So we have that time, no, during the Spanish colonization, we have a feudal theory of what they call jura regalia. No, so this is a very important concept, also a frequent term being asked during the board exams. This is what you call the regalian doctrine. So this is a legal concept, no, imposed by the colonizers to legitimize their control over the native population. They, the Spaniards, when they came to the Philippines, no, under using also this concept, they declared, no, all islands in the Philippines, no, and other conquered territories as belonging to the Spanish crown. And as a result of that declaration, you have what we call the historical massive deprivation of the right of the natives, no, to their ancestral territories. So you have the natives near Manila, Cebu, no, Zamboanga. These Filipino natives became directly under Spanish rule, but you have a lot of Filipino natives living in the hinterlands. They were not discovered, no, quote unquote, or because they resisted colonization. No, most of these natives, they're found in the southern island of Mindanao. So you have there the natives which are non-Moros or non-Muslims. Most of them, they resisted Spanish colonization, and many of them are secluded. The reason that they're secluded because basically of geographical reasons. So, well, more than half of the Philippines lost our territory to the Spaniards under the Regalian Doctrine. You have other areas of the country that remained free and practiced their customary ways and exist in their ancestral domains. As we mentioned, of course, you have indigenous peoples in the Cordilleras, no, Northern Luzon, portion of the Visayas, you know, Mindoro area. But the areas near Cebu, Iloilo, no, Bacolod, this areas or territories became directly under control. Mindanao principally became autonomous because only the areas of Zamboanga, portion of Cagayan, no, or small areas of the island became under Spanish rule. Most of the areas in Mindanao, no, including the Sulu, Tawi-Tawi, Basilan, no, the areas where our Muslim brothers stayed, were not conquered by the Spaniards. And basically animists, no, these so-called natives, they were able to preserve their environments and protect their natural bounties. So they have their own political, socio-economic, and cultural structures. And they were protected. They were protected from annihilation and even persisted Spanish colonization until the withdrawal of the Spaniards, no, and with the advent of the Americans. So for more than three centuries, you have what we call Filipino natives who were not directly, no, under Spanish control. But as far as the Spaniards were concerned, they already declared the entire 7,000 islands as part of the Spanish crown. While many of these natives survived Spanish colonization, they, however, no, succumbed to the Americans who arrived in the archipelago at the close of the 19th century. So more natives became under American rule because the Americans were more systematic, no, in their colonization. In fact, the recorded all-time human rights violations were committed by the Americans in the Mindanao area, where you have practically thousands, no, of Filipino Muslims who were massacred, no, by the Americans. That is documented, no, in our history. In fact, the caliber 45 was invented as part of the pacification campaign by the Americans in Mindanao. Spain employed physical terror and force and terror, and of course, in addition, also religion. The Americans, or the United States of America, effectively exploited the legal system as a substitute for tyranny and brute force. So the Americans were more systematic, no, because they were able to employ the legal system. No? In fact, they absorbed, they continued, no, the system, the feudal theory of the Regalian Doctrine. The American colonial rule established the Bureau of Non-Christian Tribes in 1901 to integrate the so-called ethnic minorities, no, into the national mainstream. No, again, Bureau of Non-Christian Tribes in 1901. So this was a defining moment, as it illegally consummated and forced assimilation of the indigenous peoples, no, who were no longer distinct peoples but were now non-Christian tribes. So doon nagsimula yung categorization ng non-Christian tribes, no, because the Spaniards were Catholics, the Americans were mostly Protestants. So Catholics and Protestants, they're both Christians. Yung mga naiwan, they were categorized as non-Christian. This assimilation was followed by the passage of laws excluding them from their own lands, classified by colonial rule. No, during the American period, they classified lands into public parks, forest reserves, town sites, military and government reservations. So ironically, it was during the American regime, no, panahon ng mga American, that the Philippine Supreme Court, no, of course, under Spanish American rule, rendered a landmark decision on ancestral lands. No, that case of Mateo Carino versus Insular Government. That is the legal basis, no, legal basis for the campaign, worldwide campaign of indigenous people to advance their rights. Now, in this case, no, this landmark case of Mateo Carino versus Insular Government, the Philippine Supreme Court, no, of course, under the American rule, declared that ancestral lands and domains were never part of the public domain. Okay, nakuha niyo yung importance. Ibig sabihin, they're excluded from the Regalian Doctrine, in short. Tinuturo ka sa atin, Regalian Doctrine, no, as part of yung right of government, no, to claim ownership of all lands. But in this case of Carino versus Insular Government, the court declared that ancestral lands and domains were never part of the public domain or subject to state ownership, for the simple reason that these lands remain with the unconquered indigenous peoples. So iba yung conception, no? This is an exception to the regalian doctrine, the ancestral lands. And therefore, because they become they're unconquered indigenous peoples, they retain their status as private lands, owned either by clans or individuals. So yung Carreño doctrine is still a good doctrine, in fact enshrined to sa IPRA law. Eventually naging IPRA law yung doctrine in Carreño. Sabi nga nila, no, the doctrine in Carreño before the advent of IPRA law was honored more in the breach than in the observance, as various laws were passed, no, eventually dispossessing indigenous peoples of their ancestral domains. Okay, after the Americans, quickly na tayo, no, during the Philippine Republic, ancestral territories became resettlement areas under the Commonwealth period. No, under the Commonwealth period, we have Commonwealth Act number 141, otherwise known as the Public Land Law. This is a favorite question, no? Yung IPRA law, what is the Public Land Law? The answer is Commonwealth Act number 141, which among others vested in the President of the Philippines with the power to classify and reclassify lands. Diyan nagsimula. No, binigyan yung poder, yung presidente, the power to classify and reclassify lands. As a result of this law, no, Commonwealth Act number 141, otherwise known as Public Land Law, succeeding presidents issued various proclamations reserving indigenous territories for public use, effectively excluding the indigenous peoples from enjoyment of their rights. Okay, formally excluding yung karapatan ng mga IPs natin, no, indigenous peoples, by presidential proclamation. Now fast forward, martial law era, panahon ni President Marcos Sr., Presidential Decree number 705 was passed, which declared all lands 18% in slope or over part of the public domain. Lumabas din to sa board exams, ha, yung Presidential Decree number 705. So this is one way for you also to appreciate yung historical perspective ng mga batas natin. Now again, Presidential Decree number 705 declared all lands 18% in slope, no, yung angulo, medyo kung matarik na, more than 18%, they're part of the public domain, imposing upon indigenous populations the status of squatters on their own lands, as most of them inhabited the highlands. Okay, yan yung logic. Because of the passage of Presidential Decree number 705, naging public domain yung tinitirhan ng mga kapatid natin, no, ng mga indigenous peoples. So the Marcos administration, Senior, further offered indigenous territories to mining and logging concession, buong Pilipinas to, no? And other large-scale development projects like dams funded by foreign investors, seduced by tax incentives, and a lack of regulatory climate. Now, Philippine laws foster a natural resource management paradigm, no, that rallies around the regalian doctrine and the concept of eminent domain. Ito yung tinuturo sa atin as a traditional concept, yung concept of eminent domain at saka regalian doctrine. These are terms frequently asked also in the board exams. Now, since the Americans occupied the Philippines, wide tracts of ancestral territories have lost to the state, either because they were regarded as state property, no, under the regalian doctrine, or were forcibly taken from the indigenous peoples for public use. So we have the legal political system. They became a substitute for force to legalize the methodical confiscation of ancestral territories. So you have yung Spaniards, dinagdagan ng Americans, pagdating after the Commonwealth, after the Second World War, yung mga laws, no, that further confiscated or even dispossess indigenous communities. Malapit na tayo, no, sa more recent na mga events. Eventually, we have the 1987 Constitution. Ano nakalagay sa 1987 Constitution? It mandated that the state shall protect the rights of indigenous cultural communities to their ancestral lands to ensure their economic, social, and cultural well-being. So enshrined na, nilagay na sa Constitution. Wala yan sa previous constitutions natin, no? In the 1987 Constitution, nilagay dyan yung protection ng mga karapatan ng mga indigenous cultural communities. It stated there, the state shall recognize, respect, and protect the rights of indigenous cultural communities to preserve and develop their cultures, traditions, and institutions. Sinabi ng Constitution yan, no? These rights will be considered in the formulation of national plans and development. So naging anchor, no, the 1987 Constitution became the anchor for the conceptualization and eventually the passage of the IPRA law. So these constitutional promises, no, nilagay dyan, more of declarative statements, have, on the other hand, to be regarded in the light of other provisions of the Constitution. So it situates the protection of indigenous rights within the framework of national unity and development and subordinates the protection of indigenous peoples' ancestral territories to the provisions of this constitution and national development policies and programs. So, ibig sabihin, kahit na yung conception na yung mga indigenous lands natin, they're not part of the public domain, sinabi ng 1987 constitution na the indigenous rights, no, should be construed in addition or in the light of other provisions of the Constitution. They will not be treated as stand-alone provisions, but they should be treated in tandem with the other provisions of the Constitution. The Constitution, the 1987 Constitution, mandates a natural resource management system, no, with the Regalian Doctrine at still at its bedrock. So kahit na sinabi na this the indigenous areas are private lands na and therefore excluded from the Regalian Doctrine, pagdating sa 1987 Constitution, sinabi diyan, no, na the core of the Constitution is still the Regalian Doctrine, which is considered as yung universal feudal theory that all lands were held from the crown. So imagine, pagdating ng mga Spaniards, dineclare lang nila na buong 7,000 islands part of the Spanish crown. Now that is what you call yung feudal theory of state ownership. And that this doctrine of Regalian Doctrine eventually evolved into ownership in the state, no, as rather than that vest, no, ownership of these lands or territories in favor of the state, no, and in that case, the Spanish crown. So the Regalian Doctrine is the anchor provision that evolved, no, in the Constitution, which states that all lands of the public domain, waters, minerals, coal, petroleum, and other mineral oils, all forms of potential energy, fisheries, forests or timber, wildlife, flora and fauna, and other natural resources are owned by the state. Dineclare na ginawang provision sa Constitution. Although may exception, it created an exception, no, a big exception involving indigenous lands, ginawa ng anchor provision sa Constitution, all lands, no, public domain. In fact, all forces of potential energy, No, you have fisheries, forest, timber, wildlife, flora and fauna, they're owned by the state. So as a result of the 1987 constitution, as a result of a lot of representations, struggle, no, of the indigenous peoples, Republic Act number 8371 was passed. Now, finally, so this is what you call the Indigenous Peoples' Rights Act of 1997. This has been asked repeatedly. No, dapat bonus question na to. Kung tanungin sa board exam, no, you have Republic Act number 8371, which recognizes, protects, and promotes the rights of indigenous people and cultural communities. Okay, so yun yung, that's the title of the law. So how do you define indigenous cultural communities or ICC or indigenous peoples or IPs? ICC stands for indigenous cultural communities. IP stands for indigenous peoples. As defined under this law, they are, or they refer to a group of people or homogeneous societies identified by self-ascription. Ang ibig sabihin ng self-ascription, ikaw mismo, kinonsider mo na sarili mo, no, you're part of the Iguro tribe, no, yung ibig sabihin ng self-ascription, or you're part of the Manobo tribe, and ascription by other, no, or other persons are considering you as part of yung IPs, and who have lived continuously as organized community on communally bounded and defined territory, and who have under claims of ownership since time immemorial. Okay? So, ibig sabihin ng since time immemorial, yung mga ninuno mo pa, nakatira ka sa bundok, nasa Cordillera ka, o di ba sa mga kabundukan ng Mindanao, nakatira ka dyan sa bundok, no, for several years, consider mo yung lupa mo na yours, no, ito yung concept ng indigenous cultural communities. Tinawag mo sarili mo as Blaan, tinawag mo yung sarili mo as Manobo, tinawag mo as Igorot, that is by self-ascription. O di ba tinawag ka ng ibang tao as Igorot, Manobo, no? So that is the meaning of this, ano to, yung definition. And they have occupied, possess, customs, tradition, and other distinctive cultural traits, or have, through resistance to political, social, and cultural inroads of colonization, non-indigenous religions and culture became historically differentiated from the majority of Filipinos. Diba? You go to the Cordilleras, no? Areas of Kalinga, Apayao, kita mo dyan, areas talaga na even yung how they dress, no, although medyo modern na yung mga new generation, but yung mga naunang mga unang tao, no, may they have special na mga customs, mga practices. You go south, no, because 60% pala plus, no, 60% of indigenous Filipinos in the Philippines are based in Mindanao. Nandito yung more than half of indigenous Filipino, no, you have the Blaan, Manobo, Tiboli, no, dyan sa Davao regions, marami sila dyan, no? Pag akyat mo sa bundok, the younger generation, they dress just like us, no? Yung mga lowlands na Filipinos, but pag yung the ano to, the older ones, they still maintain their own attire, no? Their culture and even yung practices. So there's a historical differentiation sa kanila, no? That is the definition of ICC at saka IPs. So ICC saka IPs, they include peoples who are regarded as indigenous on account of their descent from the populations which inhabited the country. For example, anak ka ng ano to, Igorot, no, or Tirura, or Manobo, or Blaan, no, considered IP ka pa rin. Okay? So kung yung mga ninuno mo at the time of the conquest or colonization were really the ano to, mga indigenous peoples, or at the or at the time of inroads of non-indigenous religions and cultures or establishment. No, pagdating ng mga Americans, when the Americans came, you have Protestants, no? Protestant churches converting these indigenous Filipinos, no, sa mga kabundukan, they compete with the Roman Catholics in converting these indigenous peoples into the Christian religion. No? Tanong lang, anong Christian religion? Kasi in Christianity, marami na tayong kanya-kanyang mga sekta or ano to, yung religion. So you're also part of ICC or IP if you retain some or all of your own social, economic, cultural, and political institutions. But they have been displaced from their traditional domains, no, dispossessed pagpasok ng mga Americans, either, of course, sa mga Spaniards, matagal na yon. The more recent yung mga Americans, then the more recent yung pagpasok ng mga, for example, sa Mindanao, no? Pagpasok ng mga northern at saka central Philippines na mga Filipinos into Mindanao. No? Because ginawang kwan yun, ginawang national policy of settlement. Remember, meron tayong National Land Settlement Administration. You have millions of Filipinos from Luzon, from the Visayas. They were promised lands here in Mindanao, including my parents. No, my parents, they came from the Visayas. They migrated in Mindanao. And kaming anak, mga anak ngayon, officially based in the island of Mindanao. But effectively, that result in the displacement of yung tinatawag na traditional domains of these ICC saka IPs. As a result of that, they may have resettled outside of their ancestral domains. So what about ancestral domains? What is an ancestral domain? So this refers to all areas generally belonging to ICCs at saka IPs. They comprise lands, inland waters, coastal areas, natural resources, and all natural resources therein, held under a claim of ownership, occupied or possessed by ICCs, IPs, themselves or through their ancestors, communally or individually since time immemorial. Now, when you say since time immemorial, yung mga ninuno-nuno mo pa, no? Even bago dumating yung mga Espanyol, andyan na yung mga ninuno mo, nakatira na kayo dyan, no? Continuously to the present, except when interrupted by war, force majeure, or displacement by force, deceit, stealth, or as a consequence of government projects or any other voluntary dealings entered into by governments and private individuals, corporations, and which are necessary to ensure their economic, social, and cultural welfare. In short, no, over centuries, over the years, these IPs were dispossessed, no, either by government action, by law, no, or even by war, or even by deceit, no, na isahan sila. Kasi yung concept kasi ng ownership ng mga IPs natin, they're not based on the concept of yung torrent system. Now remember, we discussed about yung torrent system, na yung basis ng ownership mo is yung torrent system, yung titulo na hawak mo. Once na hawak mo yung titulo, you're the owner. But before the torrent system, iba yung concept ng ownership. No, wala namang papel-papel yan eh. May-ari or the ones who are owning were the tribes, no, or communities. So wala even yung concept ng individual. Ano to, individual ownership. Now, individual ownership became the norm with the advent of the torrent system. So anong kasama pa ng mga ancestral domains? They include ancestral land, forest, pasture, residential, agricultural, and other individually owned, whether alienable and disposable or otherwise. Kasama class yung residential sa agricultural, no? As part of yung ancestral domains, no? Is there an exception? Ang sabi ng IPRALO, may exception if these residential areas were already subject to private rights. Ibig sabihin ko, napatituluhan na yan, yung mga areas ng ancestral domain, excluded na siya sa coverage ng IPRALO. Kasama na rin dyan yung hunting grounds, burial grounds, worship areas, bodies of water, mineral, and other natural resources. Kasama yan sa definition ng ancestral domains. And lands which may no longer be exclusively occupied, no, by ICC saka IPIS, but from which their traditionally had access for their subsistence and traditional activities. So that includes yung mga home ranges of ICC saka IPIS who are still nomadic and or shifting cultivators. So in some areas of the country, mga kabundukan natin na hindi pa napapasukan ng civilization, no? You may wonder, meron pa ba? Meron pa na mga areas, no? Mga remote areas. So this yung IPIS natin, they are still nomadic, no? Or tinatawag na shifting cultivators depending on yung weather, no? Or depending on yung mga hayop nila, they transfer from one area to another area. So you have yung definition ng ancestral lands. What about ancestral domains? What about ancestral lands? So when you talk of ancestral lands, they refer to land. No, yung lupa mismo. Occupied, possessed, and utilized by individuals, families, and clans who are members of the ICC's IPs since time immemorial. Okay? Again, bumalik tayo sa since time immemorial. Ibig sabihin dyan, before the advent of the Spaniards, andyan na yan sila, they own by themselves or through their predecessors in interest, under claims of individual or traditional group ownership, continuously to the present, except interrupted by war. Force majeure or displacement by force, deceit, stealth, or as a consequence of government projects and other voluntary dealings, no, the same pa rin, aligned dun sa ancestral domain, yung definition, entered by government and private individuals, corporations, including, but not limited to, kasama pa rin, no? Kasama pa rin yung residential lots, rice terraces or paddies, private forests, Sweden farms, and tree lots. Okay, so, andyan yung definition and distinction between what is an ancestral domain, what is an ancestral land. Of course, ang next na question na yung conception, you have yung dokumento evidencing ownership of an ancestral domain. We call that a certificate of ancestral domain title. Then you have another document evidencing some form of control over ancestral lands. You call that certificate of ancestral lands. Yung una, ang tawag sa kanya is CADT, no? Abbreviation. Yung second naman is CALT. So what is a certificate of ancestral domain title? This refers to a title formally recognizing the rights of possession and ownership of ICCs and IPs over their ancestral domains, identified and delineated in accordance with this law. So what about certificate of ancestral lands? It's a title formalizing, recognizing the rights of the ICCs and IPs over their ancestral lands. This one, no, very important concept in dealing with IPs, no, under the law. You have the concept of free and prior informed consent. No, normally you get this when you have some projects, no, in the areas considered as part of ancestral domain or ancestral land. So this means consensus of all members of the ICC's IPs. This is to be determined in accordance with their respective customary laws and practices, free from any external manipulation, interference, and coercion, and obtained after fully disclosing the intent and scope of the activity in a language and process understandable to the community. For example, magtayo ng mining company, no? There's mining operation, there's a big project sa area na within the ancestral territory, dadaan yan sa yung tinatawag na free and prior informed consent. So more or less consensual siya, no? Kailangan i-consult mo lahat, dapat lahat will agree, no, by consensus. How do you arrive at that process? Through the respective customary laws and practices. So yung mga yung tinatawag natin mga native population natin, no, or part of our cultural communities, they have their own customary laws and practices on how to secure, no, the consensus of all members of their clan. Na yung time immemorial, di ba? Pabalik-balik natin to sinabi in previous slides. When you say time immemorial, this refers to a period of time when as far as memory can go, ay ma-recollect ng memory natin, even beyond the Spanish period, you have certain ICCs or IPs are known to have occupied, possessed, no, in the concept of honor and utilize a defined territory devolved to them by operation of customary law or inherited from their ancestors in accordance with their customs and traditions. What about native title? Native title, ito yung sinasabi sa Carreño na case na doctrine na hindi ibig sabihin there's a regalian doctrine, no, under yung feudal theory imposed by the Spaniards na nilegalized by the Americans. All lands under the all lands within the Philippine territory are part of the state. Exception dyan yung native title. Ano yung native title? This refers to pre-conquest rights. No, bago pa dumating yung mga Spaniards, to lands and domains which as far as memory reaches have been held and have been held under a claim of private ownership by ICCs and IPs, they have they have never been public lands. And are thus indisputably presumed to have been held that way since before the Spanish conquest. So meron tayong concept dito sa Philippines na native title, no? Because before the advent of the Spaniards, yung areas na yan, no, may mga areas that the Spaniards were able to conquer, but of course not the entire islands of the Philippines. So i-honor yung tinatawag nating native title, no? This native title graduated into yung Kadti at saka Kalti. What about customary laws, no? At saka customary claims. So when you communal claims sa customary laws. So when you talk of communal claims, they refer to claims on land, resources and rights thereon belonging to the whole community within a defined territory. Customary laws. So when you say customary laws, not necessarily written, no? Even unwritten rules, usages, customs and practices traditionally and continually recognized, accepted and observed by respective ICCs at IPs. So yung mga pa natin, mga members of cultural communities, they have, may mga batas din sila na sinusunod. Now, of course, these laws, they're subordinate to the national law. No, but they have practices na unwritten. Nirespect din ng national law yan. No, if these practices are not contrary to national laws. Which brings us to the yung tinatawag na indigenous concept of ownership. Okay? Ano ibig sabihin ng indigenous concept of ownership? This sustains the view that ancestral domains and all resources found therein shall serve as the material basis of their cultural integrity. Now, the indigenous concept of ownership generally holds that ancestral domains are the ICC's IP's private but community property. Nakuha nyo yung concept ng indigenous concept of ownership? yung mga ancestral domains daw, they are private. No, private siya, but communal na property. Hindi siya, for example, kinilame niya ng isang clan, hindi ibig sabihin si Pedro na member ng clan, sa kanya yon. No, ibig sabihin lang yung clan mismo, they hold ownership over this property, this tinatawag na community property. And according to this concept, this community property belongs to all generations. And therefore, no, which is central sa ipralo natin, they cannot be sold, disposed, or destroyed. So, yun yung concept natin sa ipralo, yung mga ancestral lands, they cannot be sold. So that is the limitation. No? Good question also yan, no, sa board exam. Whether or not IPRA lands can be sold, the answer is no. But can they be transferred? Yes. No? It can be transferred, land at saka property rights to and among members of the same ICC's IPs, subject to customary laws and traditions of the community concerned. So may kanya-kanyang ownership concept yung mga ano to, indigenous peoples natin. No? So kung yung concept ownership nila, will be followed. No? Can they be transferred? Pwede i-transfer, but the transfer should belong to the same member of the cultural community. Now, can they be transferred, no, to a non-member of the concerned ICC or IP? Okay? Apparently, pwede siyang i-transfer ng yung transfer ng rights can be short of yung ownership, no? For example, rentahan mo. Rentahan mo. So, ang sinasabi lang dito, pwede mong gawin 'yan, no, as long as the transfer is not tainted by vitiated consent of the ICC sa IPs, kasi most of the mga indigenous peoples natin, they're not educated. Siguro may narinig tayo na ito, marami ng yung some areas na members ng ano to, mga IPs, mga IP communities na nakapagtapos na sa kolehiyo. No, but in many areas konti lang yung ang naabot nila elementary, no, or high school, tapos they cannot afford to send their children to college. So sabi nila kung minsan naiisahan, no, the members of the cultural communities, they were ano to, they were for a while, ah, sa class, for a while. So merong kwan dito na sa yung right to redemption under this slide. Binibigyan sa ng right to redeem within a period not exceeding 15 years from the date of transfer, no? Right to redeem in case of transfer of land or property rights. So this is a difficult, considered as moderate or difficult question if asked in the board exam. How many, what is the prescriptive period for right to redemption under the IPRA law? The answer is 15 years. Now, anong ahensya ng government which supervises, no, or monitors or regulates, no, yung IPs natin? We have yung agency called the National Commission on IPs or NCIP. So this shall be the primary government agency responsible for the formulation and implementation of policies, plans, and programs to promote and protect the rights and well-being of ICCs at IPs and recognition of their ancestral domains as well as their rights thereto. In short, question is asked, anong agency ng government, no, that is implementing yung Republic Act 8371? The short answer is NCIP or National Commission on IPs. So yung NCIP natin, it has regional offices. Ano yung jurisdiction ng opisina na to? all claims and disputes involving rights of ICC's IPs, no, provided that no such dispute shall be brought to the NCIP unless the parties have exhausted all remedies provided under their customary law. So bago mo iakyat sa NCIP, if there's dispute or conflict, i-resolve muna ng clan, ng tribe mismo, in accordance with their customary laws. For this purpose, a certification shall be issued by the Council of Elders, leaders who participated in the attempt to settle the dispute, that the same has not been resolved, which certification shall be a condition precedent to the filing of a petition with the NCIP. Ibig sabihin dito, class, bago iakyat, kung may kaso-kaso dyan, no, ng those disputes involving mga indigenous communities or indigenous peoples, there's the concept ng exhaustion of remedies. Dapat i-areglo nila in accordance with their customary laws. So sino usually nag-handle niyan? Lahat ng mga tribes natin, they have yung council of elders, o di ba yung leaders. So they should be given the chance to settle the dispute. So bakit important yung discussion natin ng Republic Act 8371? Now let's start with statistics, figures, why we are giving so much importance on yung ano to, yung ancestral lands natin. Let's just check yung land classification in the Philippines as of 2021. Now, makita natin yan. Pinakamarami yung forest land. Now, almost half o andiyan nakalagay almost 15 million. No, 15 million ba yan? Oh, 15 million. 15 million kasi 1,000 hectares, no? Kasi 15,000 hectares times 1,000. So yung total forest land in the country, no? Tanungin kayo diyan, no? Ang figure is nasa vicinity ng 15 million. Yung considered as AND certified nasa 14 million. Then you have timberland, no? I think that's 10 million. Established forest reserves nasa 3 million. Okay? So that is yung land classification natin hanggang sa baba, na including yung mga civil reservations, military at saka naval reservations, saka mga fish pond. So yung top three, you have forest land, you have AND, you have yung timberland. E saan yung ancestral land dyan? So this is land classification lang without considering yung ancestral land natin, no? Ito yung lumalabas na ano to na figures, no, based sa previous slide natin. Out of this na mga forest lands natin, AND, timberland, forest reserves, at saka national parks, yung ancestral lands na binigay sa mga katutubo, no, yung mga Filipino cultural communities, already total to 7.7 million hectares. Laki, no? Malaking area na nabigay sa mga indigenous cultural communities. Now, in fact, it's almost half of the forest land in this country. So yung ancestral lands natin dito, they cross, no, yung forest land, AND, at saka timberland, saka forest reserves. So meron silang mga areas dyan na considered as part of the ancestral domain. Ulitin natin, ha, ancestral lands nasa 7.7 million hectares. Kung tanungin sa board exam yan, vicinity of 7 to 8 yung final choice. But yung forest lands, nasa 15 to 16 million. No? AND, 14 million hectares. Now, sa sobrang dami na nabigay sa indigenous people natin, no, on the Republic Act 8371, yung Department of Agriculture, no, they were asking the IPs to transform portions of their ideal ancestral lands into food production areas to ensure stable food supply. Yun yung effect, no, na medyo limited yung agricultural areas natin, nabawasan pa, no, because portion of these agricultural areas were turned over to mga ancestral or converted into ancestral domains at saka ancestral lands. In fact, the as we mentioned kanina, the official figure, no, according to NCIP is 7.7 million hectares na ngayon. Or out of the total 30 million hectares, no, of land in here in the Philippines, more than 1/4 is already controlled or under the control and possession or ownership of our indigenous peoples. Malaki yan, no? 7.7 million hectares out of 30 million hectares. Eh, di ba? Na, limited na yung area ng Pilipinas. Binigay pa yung 1/4 of our total land area to our cultural communities. By law. By law. So that is how significant, no, yung ancestral lands sa real estate industry in the country. Kaya yung DA, nakikiusap na. Oh, sa kadami ng binigay sa inyo, almost 1/4 ng territory ng bansa natin, make it more productive. No? Because most of these ancestral lands are idle. Nakatiwangwang lang siya. No? Sabi ng sabi ng DA, gawin yung vegetable at saka high value crop farms yan. Which should be the case. No? Which should be the case because for those of you na umuwi sa probinsya, you'll be surprised. No? You have many areas already under considered as part of ancestral domain. So anong opportunity sa real estate industry? This 7 million hectares. They can develop into diversified farming, no, integrated vegetable at saka livestock raising. That will provide yung cultural communities natin with source of food but also source of additional income. So in a way, parang intervention na ginawa, no? Since 1987 Constitution, gumawa ng intervention kahit na paano, nabalik yung mga lupa na nakuha sa mga natives, no? They call that natives or Filipino cultural communities. But ngayon, nabalik nga ang problema naman, they're not productive. Now in Mindanao, no? Mindanao is the center of the IPs in the entire country. Now out of 15 million Filipino IPs, the population natin ngayon is 110 million, 'di ba? Filipinos, mga around 15%, no? Or less than 50%. Siguro mga 12% of Filipinos are members of cultural community. No, tama ba? Kasi 15 million over 110 million, parang more than 10% or roughly 1 out of 10 Filipino is a member of the cultural community. Imagine 1/10 lang sila of the national population and yet they control more than 25% of the lands. So parang historical correction of what happened to our indigenous cultural communities. So at least dito sa Philippines, no, we're better than the Americans of what they did sa American Indians. Di ba? Sa mga American Indians, ganun din ginawa ng ginawa ng colonizers sa America. They dispossess yung American Indians of millions of hectares of land. Pero anong binalik nila sa mga American Indians, no? Konti lang. Sa atin dito, medyo we're I think better than the Americans in giving back, no, sa mga areas na mga lupa na that we secured, no, or mga ancestors natin secured or our government dispossessed areas or controlled areas or areas declared under the Regalian Doctrine as part of state property. So in effect dito, to understand yung concept ng ancestral lands, yung 7.7 million hectares, actually they cross forest reserves, they cross timberland, they cross A&D, they cross forest lands. Pero ang total niyan umabot ng 7.7 million hectares. Of course, if the area is ancestral land, part of forest land, they cannot be sold kasi forest land yan eh. But you have also ancestral lands kasi na reclassified as ano to, reclassified from agriculture to other uses, no, like residential, commercial, industrial, and other institutional uses. Napasukan pa rin niya ng ancestral domain law. Okay? So that is our short ano to, presentation ng IPRA.